somebody has been doing some gardening, and that somebody is not me. I was bringing out the food to feed the critters. I looked out the door before I opened it up and noticed an early morning visitor, a rabbit, in my asparagus beds. Now, my asparagus beds are, I believe, almost 20 inches high. So they're relatively rabbit-proof for the rabbits that I have around here. They cannot climb over the side of the bed. Well, I watched. I just stood at the window and I watched, mainly because I love watching the wildlife. But I watched out of curiosity because this rabbit was doing something that I never saw a rabbit do before, I guess because I never really paid attention. This rabbit was nibbling on this particular morsel. This is compost that I haven't dug into my garden yet. I just threw it on here last year, right before winter got here. It's a chunk of compost. I thought it was a he, but she was nibbling on this, and then she set it down. Then she picked up another one, nibble it, set it down, and she was going all around here. There was grass growing all over the place. She was going along here, picking up dead pieces of stuff, bringing it over here. Yes, yes she was. And she was tucking it into this hole. Yeah, you can probably imagine what I'm getting at right here. And then she picked up, you know, rabbits are really dexterous. She picked up a piece of compost and placed it on top and then took her little paws and went like that. And then the way that she got into this bed, she didn't hop into here because it's too high. What she did was she hopped from another bed over into here. Tricky little boogers. You don't think of rabbits as being that smart. Now, rabbits will only come around generally at night for what I'm going to be discovering. I know what I'm expecting here, and I want to show you. So I'm going to bring you over here, and let's examine this together. She has dug a hole and filled it with dry grass. That is a sure sign that a rabbit is getting ready to have babies, and she's preparing a nest. Oh, good. Good, good, good. Now, this one has nothing but grass in it. You can see it's a hole. I'm going to pull all the grass out because I don't want this here. Look at all this dead grass. Yeah, she did all the weeding for me. I really do appreciate that. Thank you, Mrs. Bunny. The thing is, I don't want all this in my garden because what she's doing is she's getting ready to have babies. And a rabbit will dig a hole, not a deep hole, just a shallow hole. I'm going to show you what this looks like. So just in case you see this in your garden, see, it doesn't go in that far. It only goes in about maybe 8 inches. And she dug in there into my asparagus patch. Then she puts all this grass in there. Now, let me back it up. What she'll do is line it with dry grass. And then when she's ready to have babies, one night she'll come over and tear out a lot of fur from her belly and around her abdomen and line it with fur. Oh, it's beautiful. And it's soft, too. I've felt those before. And she'll line it with that, put some babies in there, give birth, and then cover it all up with this stuff and camouflage it. And she'll stay away from this all the time and only come back at night for about 20 minutes. That's it. 20 minutes. Feed them really quick and then leave. Baby bunnies never really spend any time with their parents except for a quick feeding once a night. And that's absolutely it. Now, I tore this nest apart not because I'm mean, but because I don't want rabbits being raised in my garden. Oh, absolutely not. No, 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 no. Yes, I do love nature. I'm not a nature hater. I do love nature, but I do draw the line. I have 3 acres. And they can have anything they want in the 3 acres. This little tiny square here, this is mine. This is mine. You can't have it. And even though the bunnies are going to be adorable when she has bunnies, she can dig a hole somewhere else if she wants. Hey, Tiki, how you doing? The only animals that are allowed in my garden are me and my little four-legged canines. Those are the only ones. Hey, Rascal, how you doing? And let me tell you just one more thing about bunnies. What they'll do is they'll dig a hole, make babies like I told you, and then they'll stay away. And you think, well, that doesn't really ruin your garden. It just makes a hole. Well, what happens is when the baby bunnies get old enough to leave the nest, what they'll do is they'll start wandering around, coming out of the hole, for short periods of time, and they'll eat everything around there to nibble. They don't go wandering off right off the bat. They'll wander around, and I don't want them nibbling on anything that's growing in my garden because there's going to be tender shoots. I calculate by the time those baby bunnies come out, my little plants, my radishes, my onions, my everything are going to be tender and delicious. And even though I might want to eat them, I don't want the bunnies to eat them. I just wanted to show you that. It was a surprise thing. I had no intention of filming this today, but I saw this happening, and I thought maybe I'd include that in today's program. One thing I want to mention is, before I get started, I got things to do, and I'm not just going to sit here and talk. The seed giveaway thing, remember the seed giveaway thing? I didn't forget about that. I just had other things to film, but I went to the program, and I selected not 12 people. No. I said I was going to select 12 people, send you messages, and then you get back to me. Remember the directions, and then I would send you those seeds. Well, I figured it out with the seeds, and I made 24. I don't know why I'm doing that. That's not 24. I made 24 envelopes, twice the amount. And I sent 24 people the messages, and 23 of you have responded back. Your packages are already on the way. You should be receiving them. I actually mailed them out a couple days ago, so you should be receiving them today. Keep an eye out for your mailbox. Those of you who I sent messages to, you know who you are. I'm not going to mention their names, but I wanted to let you guys know that, yes, I did do that. I sent out the seeds that are ready to go, and as a special bonus, just for the heck of it, I found some other seeds that I know you're going to like. I'm not going to tell you what they are. They're a surprise, and they'll be coming in your package more than you would imagine. And these are all something that I want you to spread around and help everybody else grow stuff. So I wanted to mention that to close up that seed giveaway thing. Thank you, everybody, for posting on the video. I really do appreciate it. Okay, now that we have all of that taken care of and we discovered little bunny, I have something I want to plant today. Yes, because our frost is, our frost isn't quite done yet. But our snow and ice, we had this crazy storm go through, and everybody was talking about it. There were tornadoes down south. There was thunderstorms over to the east. There was something like, a couple feet of snow in Minnesota. We didn't get that much. We just got an ice storm, and what an ice storm it was. The thing about it is it really put my garden on hold like everybody else's. This is like the spring that would never get here. But today I have a early crop, which is a cold, hardy crop that I can plant right now. I don't know what this is. Oh, something. There's a seed in my garden. I don't know what this is. It almost looks like a pistachio. I don't know. It could be anything. I know it's not a rock. It's a seed. Oh, you know what it was? It was probably in this pot of soil that I dumped off over here. One of my hyacinths. Ooh, well, that's what's left of my hyacinth. It died in the pot in the voodoo garden. Ooh, that's mushy. And I tossed the potting soil out here. What I do is whenever the plants die, I come out and throw the potting soil into my garden because I don't want to waste perfectly good potting soil. And then I dig it in with my garden. So every now and then you're going to see perlite in my garden. Oh, let's get to the planting of the stuff. Sniff the hole. Yeah. Smells like something, doesn't it? You know what it smells like. You don't know what it smells like. Anyway, I'm not going to show you the hole. All it is a hole. Well, Big Head and Little Head came over to visit, and they do that every now and then, and I really do enjoy it. What happened? I'm getting distracted. I'm never going to get around to planting anything. What happened was, and I wish I could have shown this to you because I ran and got my camera and I came back and it wasn't here. I was in there feeding the chickens and I saw something out of the corner of my eye and I thought, oh God, a rat again? Really? Seriously? I thought I had all you dead. Well, it wasn't a rat. No, it wasn't a rat at all. It looked like an anemic squirrel just kind of slowly walking away from me, not hopping, not rushing, not doing anything. And then I looked even closer. It didn't have that big fuzzy tail like a squirrel. It was a weasel. Yes, it was a weasel. And I never really thought about Iowa having weasels before. So I looked it up on the internet and put it in a description. And I found out what it was. I can't remember what it was called. But what I'm going to do is after I'm done filming this, I'm going to go inside and get the name again. And I'm going to put it right here what it's called. Okay, right here. And the thing about it is they're rare. Yes, they're rare in Iowa. I guess they used to be common, but, you know, with domestication and moving the land around and stuff, they're not quite so common anymore. So that made me happy. That made me happy. Mike, me, the dogs, everybody were out walking around just the other day after I saw this. I told Mike about it. I said, I wish you could have seen it. Well, happenstance was we came around the lilacs over here, and we were going to come right down here and walk by the garden, and I saw it right here next to this ugly garage, and it was just slowly walking down from that hill over here. And I pointed out to Mike, I said, look, and Mike was just thrilled. He'd never seen a weasel in person, a wild one, in his life. And it was walking really slowly from over there to my coop. So it goes in through the side of my coop through the many holes in this old structure. Well, Big Head, Little Head came to visit that night. They discovered its burrow and tried to dig it out. Well, of course, you know, it's hard for a dog to catch a weasel because they're really, really quick and they can go into little tiny holes. I haven't seen the weasel since. So the weasel's gone, and I guess that's a smart thing that the weasel decided that this was not the place it wants to live, because first of all, they will eat little baby chicks. I read up on that. They love little baby chicks. Well, I'm raising baby chicks, as a matter of fact, and they just hatched not too long ago. I'll be showing them very, very soon, and they're adorable. Hey, just pee anywhere you want. And so the Big Heads did me a little bit of a favor, got rid of it. I really didn't want it to go, but I didn't want it to eat my chicken, so I was kind of torn a little bit. I know, I'm a horrible caretaker for my animals. But I wanted to mention that because there's this hole right in my hill, and it was messing with my mulberry tree. Now I'm going to go plant something. Hey, Big Head. I've been waiting months and months for this day. I guess they have too. Hey, Heads. Big Head and Little Head decided to show up. Where'd you put my ferret? You ridiculous dogs. Time to plant the onions. Yep. No, they're not going to help. No. They will not be digging in my garden. As much as I enjoy having the Heads come to visit, I can't even imagine what they would do in my garden. Actually, I can't imagine. That's why they're not coming into my garden. Huh. How's everybody doing in here? No rabbit nests? No mice nests? I always worry about that. Actually, I don't worry about it. I always check for that first thing, because if I have a rabbit nest in here, I want to make sure I get it out of my garden pronto before the rabbit decides to lay her eggs in my garden. Yeah, if I disturb the nest and get it out of there before she gives birth, she'll go make another nest and have babies over there. More power to her. Raise all the bunnies you want. Just don't bring them into my garden. This bed last year I used to raise that tomatillo over here and a few onions. Last fall, after I took everything out. Hey, worm! Well, that's a good sign. After I took everything out, I incorporated compost into here, and then this spring I mentioned that you need to come out and start digging up the soil and stuff to keep the weeds from getting a head start, and that's really a good idea. I do this whenever I have a moment. Now, up close, see, that's a new weed. Yes, it is. I want to make sure I disrupt their little lives before they disrupt mine. Look what we have here. A battle of the titans. It's a good day to be the Big Head and Little Head. They do enjoy their stay here. They're so much more relaxed after so many visits here for so long than when, remember when they first came here, they were crazy. And they would jump all over me and get nutty and stuff. Now they've just kind of relaxed to a playfulness and kind of an ease of being here. Yeah, I'm daycare. I am doggy daycare for these two. And then in the evening, when they see Daddy drive by, they follow his truck home. That's how it is. Okay, back to the business at hand. This is what my beds look like right now. You can see they're all basically the same. This one needs to be dug a little bit more. You can see the chunks of compost still on the surface that need to be mixed in. It's finished compost. It was from last year. And here, I might as well stop right here. These don't look like much. These are Kelsey onions that I started from seed indoors. Now, you can start your seeds in the garden, or you can start your onions from onion sets, which are little baby onions, and plant those. Or you can plant the seeds inside and grow them a little bit, then transplant them outside. Even though it's not totally warm outside yet, it's cool, and the evenings get close to frost, but not really frost, because that time is over. You can plant onions. They are very hardy in cool weather. And one thing I wanted to show you before I get started, I came out here today to unlock the gate for the first time in a while. And you remember this little tiny bed? Yeah, I got to bring this to your attention because this gave me a big fat stinking smile on my face. This is where I buried those bulbs a friend sent me from Holland, remember? And folks were telling me, Ray, you got to plant them way deeper than that. They're not going to survive the winter. Well, I don't mean any disrespect at all, but I just want to show you the reality of the situation. Look, 1, 2, 3, yep, all over the place. New sprouts. The bulbs are coming up. They survived our harsh, icy winter, and they're coming up all over the place. And I did absolutely nothing to protect them. They're just a few inches beneath the soil, and I'm going to have flowers, I think, this year. I'm very, very happy about that. Now, of course, I got to get out here. My biggest problem is the grass that grows out here. It sends rhizomes out sideways, and it comes up everywhere in the garden. That's just one of those realities, but I'm okay with that. Right next to it, this is where I grew my tomato last year. I put in some compost, raked it out. I'm going to rake it some more. This is where my onions are going. This is the shallow raised bed, the only shallow one that I have here. The other ones are the real deep ones. I'm going to use those ones for potatoes, tomatoes, a sunflower, all different kinds of stuff that require the deep, rich soil for the roots to go down. Onions, although they do send out a nice, decent root system, they don't really require super deep soil. That's where this is going to come in handy. Just a little clod breaking and last minute root pulling of these. I wanted to show you this. This is what I'm talking about. I pulled a few of them out when I was starting to dig on here. This is what I'm talking about. These grasses are incredible. Look at that. Grasses and weeds. I think this might be a dandelion. This was buried. It's got a decent sized taproot, but it was growing underneath the soil. And these are the grasses that grow around here. We have a weird grass that sends out side roots that come up all over the place. Even though I turn this soil, any little piece of root that's left over will grow something. So it's a never-ending battle out here. Now this would be different if this were an old garden that was established and I put down fabric around the outside of the garden to keep everything down. I just don't do that. Now there are other ways to do the garden to keep it totally weed-free. And if folks want to do that, I highly recommend they do. Oh, hey, look. Look who's awake. Yep. The hard workers in my garden, they just started to wake up, so I'm not going to disturb them too awful much. They're going to love this compost that I dug into here. This is as good as it's going to get. I could break up the clods even smaller. I just don't want to do that because it really doesn't make a difference. The onions are going to grow just fine in here. Now, of course, I could have grown these onions a little bit taller, but I want to get them into the ground soon. The cold nights and cool days don't bother onions one single bit. They're very good at dealing with that. I planted a few seeds to make sure that I got more than one coming out. So there's probably a couple plants in here. I'm going to plant 9. Now, by the way, I forgot to mention, these are called Kelsey onions. Kelsey onions are gigantic onions in the onion world. They're also, aside from being giant, they're delicious. They are a beautiful, sweet onion that is mild, delicious, and it actually stores pretty good. Only problem is you can't plant them right next to each other. Otherwise, they don't get quite as big, and they don't get, they're not quite as healthy. They need to be spread out. Since I have the room, I'm going to only plant 9 of them in here. Yeah, just 9. I could plant probably 12 or even more, but I choose not to. All I do is dig down. This isn't really a demo. I just figured I'd have you along. Come on, it's a nice day. Put on your old jeans, get in here, and dig. That's the fun of the garden. Now, I'm not going to plant these too awful deep, but I want to make sure that they're down deep enough to where they're sort of protected. Now, you don't see any roots coming out because these are not very old at all. Now, I'm going to plant it like this. Put the soil down. Now the soil that I had them in, the potting mix, is moist because I already watered them. Now the soil out here is very moist because of course we've been having the rain, snow, everything's moist. I don't have to water these at all. All I got to do is pop it in here, and I don't want to bury these onions all the way. I want to keep them just like this. That's it. Now as they grow up a little bit, when the bulb starts to form, they'll start pushing their way out of the soil. But for right now, they're kind of hidden. and nothing's going to be bothering them. They'll get just enough sunlight, just enough insulation to get them started. Now, if you need a little bit of advice growing onions, please feel free to ask me in the comment section below. But as the season goes on, I'm going to be telling you how I grow these, or if they don't survive, how I don't grow these. I've had pretty good luck with onions. They're really a pretty easy crop to grow, and they take very little care at all. One thing that onions do require, well, they enjoy. I can't say they require it because I've never put them to a stress test. What my onions really do enjoy is loose, rich, well-drained soil. And that, of course, means that I incorporate a lot of compost in it. They like to be watered well, which means water them deep, and then allow the soil to dry out just a little bit, not too awful much, and then water them again. They do not grow well for me if I give them extended periods of dryness. They just don't seem to do as well for me. So I make sure I water them a little bit more than I do other plants, but they don't like to be wet. Their roots will rot and the onions will start to fail. Plant them early in the spring, as soon as the temperatures are halfway decent. You know, you can even get a little bit of a frost at night and your onions will do just fine. You just don't want any real hard freezes or anything. Ain't that right, little head? Yeah. He wants to get in here and dig these things up, the little bugger. Not today. Not much of a hard thing to do to plant onions or to grow onions. And I could plant more of them in here if I wanted. I put the cups upside down to mark where the onions were so I didn't accidentally step on them. But now that I'm all done, I can take these cups back in, rinse them out, and they are all ready to go for the next thing that I want to plant. Not so difficult. Would have been kind of nice to see that ferret running around here. I keep thinking about that. But I guess it was meant to be that it's not meant to be here. Hey, little head. Did you have fun? Yeah. He's my little garden buddy, he is. Rascal's inside right now because they were out playing, and Rascal got a little bit tired because, you know, his legs are as short as thumbs. He has to run like 10 times faster than this little thing right here. I don't know where Big Head went. Big Head just went gallivanting around. They come and go as they please. Oh, it's a beautiful day, and I feel so much better now that I have dirt underneath my nails. Spring's taken a while to get here, but it's going to be well worth the wait. I got a feeling about this season. It's going to be a good year. It's going to be a really good year. Anyway, I hope it's warming up wherever you are, and your garden's going to be planted soon too. If you have any questions or comments, you just want to talk gardening, post it in the comment section below. Me or Little Head will get back to you as soon as we can. That smell of dirt is intoxicating. It's like a drug and a cure all in one. It really is. Okay, I gotta get going. You have a good week, and I'll see you here next week. Same time, same location. Well, maybe not same location, but we'll see each other next week. Have a great day. Bye.